This year, we remember the men, women, and children who were murdered on October 7th in Israel, and all those who perished since then in Israel and Gaza. Alice Shalvey, professor and educator, considered the founding mother of modern Jewish feminism in Israel. She played a leading role in progressive Jewish education for girls and equal treatment for women in marriage, employment, and more. She received the highest civilian award for lifetime achievement, the Israel Prize, in 2007. Vivian Silver, lifelong feminist and Canadian-Israeli peace activist, who was killed by Hamas during the Be'eri massacre on October 7th. Meir Shalev, a writer of fiction, memoir, biblical stories, and children's stories, considered one of the most successful and influential Israeli authors of his time. He won Israel's coveted Brenner Prize, and in 2014 was given the title of Knight of Arts and Letters. Aharon Ariel, journalist, scholar, and broadcaster, who as an editor worked on the Encyclopedia Hebraica, and as a journalist, covered the trial of Adolf Eichmann. He fought in Israel's War of Independence. Sir Ben Helfgott, survivor who became an Olympic weightlifter for his adopted country, Britain, after weighing only 80 pounds when he was liberated from a concentration camp. He won 4 British weightlifting titles, the gold medal 3 times at the Maccabiah Games in Israel, and competed twice in the Olympics. Adolfo Kaminsky, photographer, forger, smuggler, and one of the lesser-known Jewish heroes of the Holocaust, credited with saving the lives of over 14,000 Jews as part of the French Jewish resistance. Solomon Perel, German-Israeli author and motivational speaker who saved himself from death by posing as a member of the Hitler Youth during World War II. His life story is told in the 1990 film Europa, Europa, which was loosely based on his autobiography. Abraham Lempel, computer scientist who arrived in Israel as a 12-year-old orphan escaping World War II Europe. One of the fathers of the Lempel-Ziv algorithm, which revolutionized data compression, enabling technology for file formats including GIF, PDF, and MP3 files. Lempel is considered one of the greatest researchers to ever work in Israel's Technion in the 100 years of its existence. Thomas Borgenthal, survivor, human rights champion, renowned international jurist, and judge of the International Court of Justice. Believed to be the youngest survivor of Auschwitz, he wrote about his ordeal in A Lucky Child, a memoir of surviving Auschwitz as a young boy. Nechama Tech, survivor, historian, and sociology professor who pretended to be Roman Catholic during World War II to survive the Holocaust. Her book, Defiance, The Bielski Brothers, about heroic Jewish resistors, was made into the movie Defiance, starring Daniel Craig. Hedda Kleinfeld-Schachter, Holocaust survivor who, together with her husband, transformed her family's small fur business into the world's largest and most famous bridal empire, known as Kleinfeld's. Henry Kissinger, American diplomat, political scientist, geopolitical consultant and politician who advised 12 presidents from John F. Kennedy to Joe Biden and served as the United States Secretary of State and National Security Advisor in the presidential administrations of Richard Nixon and Gerald Ford between 1969 and 1977. the agreements he negotiated as Secretary of State between Israel, Egypt, and Syria stabilized borders for nearly half a century after the 1973 Arab-Israeli War. Benjamin Ferenz, American lawyer and last surviving member of the prosecuting team at the Nuremberg trials. He was only 27 when appointed chief prosecutor at the Einsatzgruppen trial, and he played a key role in negotiating the reparations agreement. Ferenz crusaded for an international criminal court and for laws to end wars of aggression. Abraham Zarim, one of the last surviving scientists from the Manhattan Project, who was also credited with developing a high-speed camera, the Zarim camera, used to study intense light sources and other phenomena. Diane Feinstein, trailblazing politician who championed gun control as mayor of San Francisco in the wake of Harvey Milk's murder, and later became a women's rights leader as the longest-serving senator from California and the longest-tenured female senator in history. Charles Silverstein, activist and psychologist who persuaded the American Psychiatric Association in 1973 to declassify homosexuality as a mental illness and spent decades of his life advancing the cause of gay rights. Robert Barron, community leader and philanthropic giant who donated millions to yeshivas, agencies, and synagogues in the U.S. and Israel. He grew up in Wichita, Kansas, when Jews were prohibited from many institutions, and today, many of the institutions that benefited from his philanthropy bear his name. Harvey Bud Meyerhoff, community leader, philanthropist, and the founding chairman of the United States Holocaust Memorial Museum. He guided the design and oversaw the construction and fundraising, allowing the museum to open on time and on budget in 1993. Cantor Philip Sherman, the most in-demand moyle in New York during his 45-year career, who performed more than 26,000 circumcisions, including for the offspring of Israeli prime ministers, movie stars, and other celebrities. A member of the Screen Actors Guild, he played rabbis in small roles on TV and in film. Judy Heumann, lifelong activist and mother of the disability rights movement, who spent decades fighting discrimination and bias from the local to the federal levels, and led the mainstreaming of disability rights into international development. Bert Freeman Bacharach, award-winning songwriter, record producer, pianist, and composer of hundreds of pop songs, widely regarded as one of the most influential figures of 20th century music, with songs like Raindrops Keep Falling on My Head, Close to You, and That's What Friends Are For. Sheldon Harnick, three-time Tony Award-winning lyricist and songwriter, best known for his collaborations with composer Jerry Bach on Fiorello, She Loves Me, and the beloved Fiddler on the Roof, a musical that has enjoyed enduring international popularity. Harnick was inducted into the Songwriters Hall of Fame in 1972 and received its highest honor, the Johnny Mercer Award, in 1990. Norman Lear, award-winning screenwriter and producer who revolutionized American television with The Jeffersons, Good Times, and All in the Family, sitcoms that were daring and imbued not only with humor, but social and political commentary, and characters like Archie Bunker, who were provocative, relatable, and enduring. Gerald Norman Springer, pioneer of daytime television, who served as the 56th mayor of Cincinnati before hosting The Jerry Springer Show, a raucous and confrontational series that became the nation's most popular tabloid-inspired talk show of the 1990s. Seymour Stein, music executive and co-founder of Sire Records, the label that signed and promoted artists including The Ramones, The Pretenders, and Madonna. Paul Paul Rubens, actor and comedian, widely known for creating and portraying Pee-wee Herman, the childlike character Rubens embodied throughout various TV and film appearances, including most famously in Pee-wee's Playhouse, an educational yet entertaining and artistic show for children meant to illustrate positive values. Chaim Topol, Israeli actor and singer, best known for his portrayal of Tevye in Fiddler on the Roof, both on Broadway and in the beloved classic film. From 1967 to 2009, he performed the role more than 3,500 times. He was a founder of Variety Israel, an organization serving children with special needs, and the Jordan River Village, a year-round camp for Arab and Jewish children with life-threatening illnesses. He was awarded the Israel Prize for Lifetime Achievement in 2015. William Greenberg Jr., a baker, famous for the fanciful cakes, brownies, and black and white cookies sold in his two Manhattan bakeries, William Greenberg Desserts, which have been patronized by generations of New Yorkers. Dick Savitt, American tennis champion, who became the first Jewish player to win both the Australian Open and Wimbledon championships in 1951. He also became the first Jewish athlete to appear on the cover of Time magazine. Owen Roizman, Oscar-nominated cinematographer, who shot many of the premier films of a generation, including The French Connection, The Exorcist, Network, Tootsie, and Wyatt Earp. He received an honorary Academy Award for his contributions to the medium. William Friedkin, Oscar-winning director of box office hits The French Connection and The Exorcist, which broke ground in the horror genre and was the first horror film to be nominated for the Academy Award for Best Picture. Richard Baranczyk, the last surviving member of the Monuments Men, the Allied military corps that hunted down and recovered millions of pieces of artwork looted by Nazis during World War II. Joanna Merlin, acting coach and casting director, who early in her career as an actress created the role of Tevye's daughter Zeitel in the original Broadway production of Fiddler on the Roof. She also had acting roles in films such as Sarah's Key, Mystic Pizza, and Fame. Robert Spencer Beau Goldman, American screenwriter and playwright whose accolades include two Academy Awards for his screenplays for One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest and Melvin and Howard. Richard Belzer, author, comedian, and actor, best known for playing Detective John Munch, a character he portrayed for 23 years in various police shows, including Homicide and Law and Order. Alan Arkin, Oscar and Tony-winning actor and filmmaker, with memorable roles in The Russians Are Coming, The Russians Are Coming, Glengarry Glen Ross, and Little Miss Sunshine. Arkin proved himself to be one of Hollywood's most versatile and in-demand actors throughout his nearly seven-decade career. Mimi Sheraton, one of the best-known restaurant critics and food writers of her generation, and the first woman to review restaurants for the New York Times. During her six-decade career, she wrote over a dozen books, including a classic history of an iconic Jewish food, The Bialy Eaters, the story of a bread and a lost world. Louise Gluck, considered by many to be one of America's most talented contemporary poets, known for her technical precision, sensitivity, and insights into loneliness, family relationships, divorce, and death. In 2020, she was awarded the Nobel Prize in Literature for her unmistakable poetic voice that, with austere beauty, makes individual existence universal. Rabbi Harold Kushner, one of America's most prominent congregational rabbis, known for his Reconstructionist views and ideological progressiveness within the conservative movement. The author of 14 books, including the best-selling When Bad Things Happen to Good People, Kushner gained widespread recognition for simplifying complex theological ideas for both Jewish and non-Jewish readers. he received the Jewish Book Council's Lifetime Achievement Award in 2007. Rabbi David Ellenson, a leader of the Reform Movement, who served as president of the Reform Seminary HUCJIR for 12 years and shaped a generation of Reform rabbis. Internationally recognized for his publications and research in the areas of Jewish religious thought, ethics, and modern Jewish history, he authored or edited 7 books and over 300 articles, and was admired among a wide circle of colleagues and students, and was referred to as everyone's favorite rabbi. Rabbi Moshe Kahn, a trailblazing teacher of Talmud Torah to women, a Rebbe who inspired excellence and celebrated the study of Gemara, who humbly and masterfully led the movement to significantly raise the level of women's learning in the Orthodox community. Rabbi Shimon Badani, one of the founders and spiritual leaders of the Sephardic Ultra-Orthodox Shas Party, who served as president of the Rabbinical Leadership Council for the Sephardic public in Israel and around the world. Rabbi Abraham Levy, English Orthodox theologian and author, who served as spiritual head of the Spanish and Portuguese Jewish community in Britain from 1962 to 2012. He played a large role in building the annual Limud Festival of Jewish Learning to its current status, when in its early days his participation was unusual among Orthodox rabbis. Mark S. Golub, trailblazing rabbi and a giant of Jewish media. He was the founder, president, and host of JBS, the first national Jewish television channel in America. Mark was an Ohev Yisrael rabbi who combined a lifelong love of Torah with a lifelong love of radio and television to pursue his dream of Jewish education in media for his entire career. In 1979, he created and hosted L'Chaim, the first most prominent Jewish magazine talk show for insightful, in-depth conversation on issues of importance to the Jewish community, which he hosted continuously for over 40 years. And during the Soviet Jewry movement of the 1990s, without speaking a word of Russian, he founded, produced, and hosted RTN, the first Russian language television network in America. Off camera, Mark was a pioneer of the Chavura movement, serving as the rabbi of 2 small congregations in Connecticut for over 50 years. He brought music, humor and laughter, curiosity, infectious energy, and boundless creativity to all his work for Jewish continuity. Zecher Tzadikim Livracha. May their memories be forever a blessing.